Derek Tony, VarsitySportsNetwork.com. We're here at Murville High School, where the Mustang football team is getting ready for the 2019 season. They open it up in a couple of weeks against Dunbar. In 2018, the Mustangs reached the Class 4A state semifinals, the first time in program history, and under Coach Patrick Nixon. They've seen things that Murville has never seen before. They've won city championships. They've gotten to the playoffs consistently. 2019 may be a big year. They are down to Class 3A. They are a championship contender. They got a lot of guys out here, Coach. And just talk about these first few weeks of practice, man.
It's been a grind. You know, we got a lot of, like you said, we got a lot of good ball players out here, a lot of new guys. We had a really good senior class last year, about 24 seniors. And, of course, there's no replacing those guys. So we're really just trying to go through the grind of, you know, teaching them the basics, really, honestly. Just basic tackling, basic alignment. We're a very talented group, but, you know, also very immature, very inexperienced. So, you know, no one's going to lay down for us. We know we got to prove ourselves. You know, last year's last year. All them other years, doesn't matter. We have to prove it all over again.
Right. Well, let's break it down a little bit. Talk about the offensive side of the ball. Talk about some veterans you're going to have back there on that side.
Well, it's always a blessing when you have a senior quarterback. You turn your starter at the center as well. It's always a blessing. I think that right there gives me a sense of comfort to knowing that our starting center is a senior, starting quarterback, both being seniors and returning. They're looking pretty good. You know, they've worked hard all offseason with 7-on-7 and in the weight room and all that good stuff. Right now, we're just trying to work on continuity with the offensive line and run game.
Right. Tell us some skill guys you're excited about.
Very excited, man. Very excited about quite a few guys. The young man by the name of Kalish Hicks. Mm-hmm. He's going to be a kid. He's going to be a rising sophomore, actually. He came on late last year to varsity as a freshman, mm-hmm. and I think this year he's going to show people who he is. Really talented kid, good kid, works hard. A kid by the name of Jared Gaskey, mm-hmm. who I believe is going to be a dynamic ball player for us, both running the ball and catching the ball. Malik Lindsey was another receiver who I think is going to do well for us, coming from another program, coming into our welcome here. Mm-hmm. And then Tyree Williams. Tyree Williams is a guy that was probably our number one receiver as far as catches last year. He had the most catches last year. He returns. I think he's going to have a phenomenal season as well.
Right. Talk about the defensive side of the ball, Coach.
That's what we're extremely young. I'm excited, you know, as a coach, because I get to coach all over again, starting fresh. But we only returned two starters from last year, so 9 new starters. And it's been fun to coach them guys. They're very talented, athletic, eager to learn, and which makes it fun. I get to coach all over again, teach all over again. I love teaching.
And special teams.
Special teams. I mean, some of them same guys I named on offense. Mm-hmm. I think from the skill side, from the speed side, return game side, I think are going to pay dividends. You know, particularly Jared Gaskin, Tyree Williams. I think they're going to do a heavy lifting as far as the return game.
Right. Talk about the growth in the team last year. You know, you guys lost, only regular season loss was to Dunbar. And recovering from that loss. Well, actually, it felt like 40 games in one. Right. But you know, just getting the guys together and, you know, making that great playoff run.
I think a lot of times through the difficulties, you know, and the perseverance, your team gets stronger. Mm-hmm. We had another incident that happened down in Delaware that, you know, we didn't get painted in the best light. Mm-hmm. And that was one of those things which resulted in me actually getting suspended for a game. Mm-hmm. You know, through those trials and tribulations, we got stronger and stronger. And that Dunbar game, of course, was very difficult, challenging, with us not being able to complete it on the original date and having to come back and then suffering the defeat. I think it just made us strong. We learned a lot from those mistakes, and I think it made us strong for that playoff run last year.
Yeah, especially when it's on the road. You won at Howard, then you won down at Paint Branch. Tough situations, but you guys are kind of built for that. Like I said, the regular season in Baltimore City kind of gets you ready for the turmoil that you're going to face.
Absolutely.
In the playoffs.
Absolutely. I've always prided myself on loving, enjoying going on the road and playing, actually. Mm-hmm. Believe it or not, I kind of enjoy playing on the road a little bit more than playing at home, to be honest. You don't have to deal with the distraction. You just show up and just play football when you're on the road. So, yeah, we definitely relish those opportunities.
Right. But just talk about this, what this program has become. And I was telling to you some of your seniors earlier, you know, Murville, you know, 15 years ago was one of those programs you kind of kept looking at, and they were, you know, 4 wins, 3 wins, you know, they might break 500. But the talent was always there. And now what you've done in now, your ninth year, I mean, arguably you're one of the area's top programs, definitely one or number two in the city the last, 5 years. Kind of talk about the culture that you've created here.
Well, it's a culture of competition. I think You know, I think we went from a program where, you know, we had guys on the team. You know, they say you're only as strong as your weakest link. We may have had some top talented guys, but we also had some guys who may not really been ready for winning football on this team. And I think we finally got into a place where, you know, man to man, all 40 or 50 men that we have on our roster are football players, and they've earned the right to wear that blue and gold. There's a lot of competition, and through competition, iron sharpens iron. You know, guys are getting better, and I think, you know, obviously the program and the rest of my coaching staff, I mean, they work tremendously hard, you know, to help develop these young men, you know, on and off the field, academically, athletically, you know, and just paying dividends.
Right, right. What's going to be three keys to success for Mervo in 2019, Coach?
Discipline. You know, discipline will definitely be one, and just how quickly we mature, how quickly we mature, and how much we believe in each other. I mean, again, it's a new group. So when those three things come together, I think we're going to be a pretty dynamic team.
All right, well, ninth season for Patrick Nixon here at Mervo. They went to the state 4A state semifinals last year. They moved down to 3A this year. They're going to be a contender again in the Baltimore City League and also in the 3A state postseason. For VarsitySportsNetwork.com, I'm Derek Tillman.